So last class we discussed about TMD and BMD. So in BMD we have business partner, contract account, and then what we did, we created the technical master data, which consists of connection object, premise and installation. Now business partner, contract account link to the installation, premise and connection object through a agreement that is called contract. Now that agreement create when we do a move-in. So what is a move-in actually? So the move-in is a process by which a business partner get the connection. So like the house is there, this is the premises, and we need to provide the services. So move-in means that person or that particular company providing the services to that house. So that is move-in. So to do the move-in, we need five steps, minimum five steps, like started with service connection. So that should be a technical feasibility to provide the connection. Okay, initial data creation. Initial data creation means we need to create the BMD and TMD to provide the move-in and the devices. The device is required to capture the meter reading from the site. And finally, we'll do the move-in. And if that person is not with the services for a longer period, we do a move out, right? So move in is a basically a process by which we are ensured that the user should get the connection. Now how the move in is happening, you can see the definition at a move in. A contract is concluded for each installation selection selected at a premise. Now this is each installation means mostly what happened, the contract and the installation relationship is always 1:1. Okay, so installation basically holds the division. When you created the installation, you can observe you have to pass the division and the key date. So the division deals with the utility types, right? So utility types means electricity, gas, water, all those stuff. Now let's the division is electricity. Then the contract agreement is based on that division would be electricity contract agreement. If it is a water, then similarly it would be for the water utility, because the contract means agreement and that agreement will be lead to the payment of the bills. Now what that agreement exactly mean, it means there should be a particular tariff, there should be particular services on which the customer will provide the money. So you can say you can use the move-in processing to make a contract billable. Payment request live at the start of supply and welcome later can also be triggered from the move-in. So when the move-in is happening, that time we create a welcome letter to acknowledge the customer that your move-in is happening, right? From this date onwards, you'll get the services from the company. So that's how this is happening. Okay, now let's understand what exactly we are doing during the move-in. So during the move-in, we are first created the business master data and technical master data. If we created the technical master data with device, so device is optional in this nature. We can first create the device, install the device, and then do the move-in, or else we can do the move-in and put the device. But the best practice is to create the device, install the device, and then do the move-in. So the technical master data, you can see connection object, premise, installation, and device, which is optional in nature. Similarly, business partner and contract will create after the move-in. So what are the steps for move-in? So we call it a move-in process. So for a move-in process, we need a POD or a address. Okay, so some person has an address or a home. Now that person or that owner or tenant of that particular premise, they will request. So they visit or call to the customer care, and the customer care will get the request from that person. Once it will get the request, it will create a business partner. Now this business partner get created. That means we understand this person need to be moving. Once that person is agree, we do a contract. So that is the agreement. We create a contract with that person and then we install the meter reading. So what is the meter reading? So during the meter installation, we put a meter reading, and During the move-in also, we put an initial meter reading. So during move-in, we put a meter reading. And after putting the meter reading, we validate that meter readings and all the details. We check whether that person provided the security money or not. Mostly the security is deposited before the move-in. Okay, so if the security is okay, then we proceed with the request of budget billing plan. If the customer requested for a budget billing plan, we ensure that in the contract, there should be option for budget billing plan. Now, if the request is not there, we need not to act on the budget billing plan and we move on. And then there is a customer contract details. Contract details means to whom we need to send the details. The addresses, all those stuff is at business partner level. If the business partner is not able to pay, who will be the next person? So customer contract, whether we need to send the invoices over email, over SMS or through messaging services. So everything need to be captured here at the contract. And once all this stuff is done, we generate a welcome letter sent to the customer. We call that as a welcome letter. And once the customer get the welcome letter, he entered. So the move-in is completed. That means the customer is now billable. Okay, till the move-in, the customer is non-billable. Once the move-in happened, the customer is billable. Okay, you are clear? Great. So exactly the move-in is happening and it is a create a contract between business partner and contract between the technical data and business master data. But the point is here, is it possible to create multiple contract for a single installation? Is it possible? The answer is no. The relationship between a contract and an installation is 1:1. But it is possible to create multiple contract for a single installation in different times. You can see in this picture, customer one is in that premise. Okay, he was a tenant there. So he creates a contract that is contract one. Now he moved out. He moved out on 1st of April 2009 and a new tenant come in that place and sees customer two. Then there is a new contract created with the customer two, but with the same installation. But you can see interval, two intervals are there. In interval one, contract one was there. In interval two, contract two is there. So that's how the relationship between installation and contract is 1:1 at a particular time period. Now, if the time period is differ and the contract is broken, then there may be multiple contracts for a single installation. So in that case, we can say for multiple time slices, for multiple different customers, there would be multiple contracts. Okay, so that is the basic logic for that. Now, once we did the move-in, okay, so the link between the master data, like technical master data and business master data, linked through a contract. Okay, you can see the business house, the SAP house, the links, those are represented as red lines, those are created. Now, in this diagram, you can see the meter or the contract is of different type or the installations are of different type. One is for electricity, gas and water. That's how there are three different contracts created, one for electricity, gas and water. As each of the utility has their own type of nature and that nature based on their tariff rates and their agreement to provide the services to the customer. That's how there are three different contracts. Okay, so now your move-in is done, the SAP house is activated and the supply is on. Okay, so once the move-in is happened, we got the contract. That means the customer is billable. We can create the billing document for that customer. Okay, as we are getting the meter reading from the meter, so we are creating the billing document for the customer. So let the customer is not like the services, what he will do? So he'll do move out. So what is the move out? Move out is just breaking the contract with the supplier or to the company which we are getting these services. And similarly, we need to send the request. So the business partner, the customer need to send a request to the company to do a move out. So what will happen during the move out? The customer report for a move out. They requested, I don't like the services, I need to stop the services. Okay, that's a request. Now, once we'll get that request over phone, email, or messaging services, or any of the communication media, we need to capture that request. Once we capture that request, we need to check the contract data of that person. Okay, why to check the contract data? Because most of the time what happened that the person when moved from one address to another address, he will stop the services, right? So first we need to ask them, are you moving out? Are you moving out from the country or moving out from the city? Or are you moving out to a different address in the same area? So all these details we need to capture from the contract. And from there, we can understand what would be the new address for that contract person, right? So to capture the new address, we need to get all the data. Okay, otherwise what will happen, we will communicate and you will not get any communication from the company. So we capture the contact data. Then what we'll do, we'll cross their old contract, means we'll stop the old contract. We capture the final meter reading. Why the final meter reading? Because we need to generate the final bill. If there is any budget billing plan allocated to that person, we need to stop that budget billing plan. Okay, then we generate the final bill. Now, when we generate the final bill, we check whether the final bill is adjusted or we need to send that amount to the contract data. So most of the time what happened with the security amount, we adjusted the final bill and whatever the rest debit amount would be there, we'll send to the customer. If there is any credit, we'll send a letter and a final invoice to the customer. And at the end, we'll give a NOC or move out confirmation letter. That's how in a deregulated market, he can get a new connection from any other companies and the move out is completed. So when we do a move out, you can see the contract is all closed. There is no red links and the business partner is moved out from the premises, the technical data. So what happened? The technical data most of the time is always kept intact because the POD is unique address in a deregulated market. So that is always intact. Whereas the tenants, if we say a tenant, they always moved in, moved out, right? But basically if there is an owner-tenant relationship, in that case, the owner, once the tenant is moved out, there would be a contract continue with the owner. Okay, so that's how the move in, move out will go on. So we have some T codes for that, right? Now let's go to do some practicals to the move in process. So I'll use your data to do the move in. Start from the business partner creation. We'll go with FPP1. Select the person, put the name, Mr. Pritam, last name is Jena. Search item is PJ. So any address, Sahid Nagar. So when there would be a lot of customers, so in that case, you should not get them with the name, like with Pritam Jena, there may be 10,000 users. Okay, so we can put PJ1, PJ2 like that. So we can give a allocation that this is the identification, right? So without going in details of the address, postal code, all the details, we can understand this person is linked to that area, right? So let me put like PJS, so I can understand this person, Pritam Jena, is come from Sahid Nagar, like that. So that's how it is easier to search the person, right? So to increase the efficiency mostly, so use the search item. If you want to know any definition, you can just put here and press F1. Okay.
Okay.
So for search item, there is no document. Okay. Anyway, city code, city Bhubaneswar. Country code is IN. You can choose this country code with search and region Odisha.
18.
Yeah. Then save. So reach your BP is created. It is 9004.
While I was creating this business partner, it was asking for payment transactions.
Okay, maybe somebody did something. I don't know. It is not asking right now. Okay. So 900466. We can go with CA means CAA1 to create the contract account. The contract account type is 01 default here. It is available. So that means it is ISU contract account. Now, I just need to fill the minimal fields which are required to create the contract account. Other fields is based on the projects. So each project has their own requirements. So based on their requirements, we configure the fields which are required or not. So, but some are mandatory, like account determination ID is mandatory. So budget billing procedure, here it is 0, it's 2. Then bill form. So the bill form uses to print the invoice amount, invoice documents. So yeah, payment term, which is useful to allocate the duration of grace period during the invoice creation. We need to provide the invoices to the customer and the customer will get a grace period to pay that invoice amount. Okay. Again, tax procedure is based on the jurisdiction. You are in which jurisdiction means which tax area, that defines which kind of tax type you need to allow. So you save this, it will create the contract account. It is 101513. So let me open a screen where I'll open the BMD. Okay, so this screen is for BMD. Let me open another screen to create the TMD. So to create the TMD, the first is creation of connection object. Okay. So to create the connection object, the T code is ES55. So the address may be same or differ based on the conditions. We also can configure like the BP address and the connection object address should be same. Okay. In that case, it will not allow you to create the connection object if your BP address will not same as your connection object address. The connection object is created. Now we need to create the premise. So ES60 is the T code to create the premise. Just pass the connection object 569. Is it? So you created 569, right? The connection object. Yeah, 569. So 569. So the premise is created, it is 269. Now we need to create the installation. T code ES30. I'm giving the key date as 1st of October 2022 because from there it will be valid. Our division type is electricity, so EL. So 269 is our premise. Then we are using the billing class as 0001. Then rate category as rate cat. Okay. So MRU as MRU. And then save. So now you created the technical data and business master data. So I'm just opening the technical master data links. Okay. Okay, so you can see we created the TMD, we created the BMD. This is the BMD, this is the TMD. Now we need to do a move-in. Okay, so what? How to do the move-in? The T code is EC50E. Okay, now here you can see there are two sections, and the top section is for the date. So I'm just giving the date as 1st of October 2022. And from the BMD part, we need to give one data, either contract account or business partner. So let's give one business partner, 900466. Similarly, from the TMD perspective, we have premise, installation, all the stuff. We need to give one data. So let's give one data from technical perspective. So it would be 280, which is your installation. Okay, now press enter. So it is asking your business partner is there. It is created a contract account. Do you want to use that? Yes. It is asking you have a installation 280. Do you want to use that? Yes. And it is giving a warning that the device is not installed at the site. Are you okay to go? They're saying yes. And then proceed. So when you proceed, it will ask, like we discuss, once we connected both TMD and BMD, it will generate a letter. Okay, welcome letter. As we don't have any configuration for welcome letter, I'm just discarding that. And once I discard that, the move-in is completed. Now it is 209 created. Now we can see the whole data here. So the whole data you can see now. It is connected. So starting from the connection object premise installation, which is TMD, that link to the BMD through a contract, which is 219, and your contract account 101519900466. So this is the move-in process. And once you did the move-in, link is established. Okay. So if you go to the installation now, you can able to see the whole data in the installation itself. So installation is the central logical entity which holds all the links, okay, between TMD, BMD, all type of data which are required to process our utility billing and other stuff. Okay, so I'm just using ES32 for the display 280. And you can see the link is established. Okay, T code for the move out is simple. We need to go with EC2. The sorry,
no, no,
EC55E. Okay, so create a move out. So let me put the move out date as 1st of October 2012. Okay. Okay, let me put 2nd of October 22. So what is our business partner?
569.
Yeah. I'm going here. Our business partner is 900466. Then technical information, our installation is 280. So below there, there will be an installation. Okay, then enter. Similarly, it is giving a warning, you don't have device. We don't have any issues with that. And it is giving all the details, okay? So if we have a meter, we need to give the final meter reading here and then press save. Okay, your move out is done. So you can see the link will be broken at your installation. So this is your installation. Let me go back and come. Now you can see no contract, no business partner. So everything is removed. What is other stuff? It is impacted. That is, you can see here the move in and move out. There is a time slice getting created. Move in is 1st of October and move out is 2nd of October. And there is a time slice getting created, right? But let it be you did a mistake during the move in itself. You did some mistake and you need to correct that. Can you correct by doing a move out? So that is not possible. So what we need to do in that case, we do a reverse of move-in. That will not create any time slices. Similarly, if you did a move out wrongly and you need to back the process intact, so we need to do a reverse of move out. So reverse of move-in and reverse of move out is useful to correct the data. Okay, so that we'll discuss in the next session.
So if you like liking our efforts, if you think that we are making good videos, informational videos, then please do like, subscribe, share, and press the bell icon here. Thank you.
Go back and let's see again what we discuss. Give me a minute. Okay. Yeah, so let's go to the screen. So we discussed everything and we saw everything in this process. We connected the BMD and TMD and we created the contract. Once we created the contract, we go through these processes, all the processes, and we completed the move-in, the welcome letter get generated. Then what we did a move-out, and after move out, we can observe that the relationship between the BMD and TMD get broken, and that's how the move out is get completed. So that is the demonstration for move in and move out. The T code for move in to see the contract is ES22, but to do the move in is EC50E, and to do the move out is EC55E. Okay, so these are the T codes for the creation of technical master data. And these are the T codes to do the move-in, reverse move-in, move-out, and reverse move-out. Okay, so I will, in the next session, we'll discuss all these reverse move-in, reverse move-out. Okay, thank you.